subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world for its history, cultural heritage, and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Yeshi, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India has been a land of interesting traditions and an artistic way of life. The people of the country are grounded to their indigenous produce and local arts and crafts. Giving you a glimpse of it, today we take you to the annual Terracotta exhibition organized in the Bhubaneswar city of Odisha, where artisans across the state showcased their artworks and celebrated their love for craft.
Stalls decked up with magnificent terracotta handicrafts drew a number of visitors to the week-long annual Terracotta exhibition, Mrutika in Bhubaneswar. Organized by the Directorate of Handicrafts and Cottage Industries, over 157 terracotta artisans displayed their products in around 100 stalls that were provided to them for free. This year, it was the 15th edition of the exhibition that saw artisans from more than 20 districts of the state. Held amid the pandemic situation, visitors along with artisans were asked to maintain social distancing and follow the other COVID-19 SOPs during the event.
हर साल भुवनेश्वर में मूर्तिका एक मूर्ता उड़ीसा से आते हैं कारीगर लोग यहाँ एक पूरा बड़ा सा मेला होता है इसमें सब कारीगर साल भर का सामान जितना भी बना कर रखते हैं सारा भी बिक जाता है।
मार्च के बाद इस तरह का एक पहला आयोजन है जिसको लेके लोगों में भी उत्साह है और सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि जैसे हम मेले में अंदर आ रहे हैं तो सैनिटाइज की व्यवस्था की गई है और आपका टेम्परेचर देखा जा रहा है। इसके अलावा जो गार्ड्स हैं यहाँ पर वो हर स्टॉल में घूम घूम के लोगों को अवेयर कर रहे हैं, जागरूकता कर रहे हैं कि आप ज़्यादा भीड़ ना करें। ये एक अच्छी बात है क्योंकि कोविड का नियम का अनुपालन करना हम सभी का उत्तरदायित्व है।
ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सिंस 2006, दिस एक्सक्लूसिव आर्ट एग्जीबिशन aims to provide a platform for the marketing of products of the clusters of terracotta and individual artisans. It also helps them to strengthen their market position along with providing an opportunity to visitors to meet the faces behind these meticulously made products. Moreover, with such amazing handicrafts available at feasible rates, customers are spoiled for choice.
Very very old place where you see lot of exhibitions happening, but this time because of COVID there has been a delay, but I think it's good that they are coming up with this and doing it, because we will also have to understand if we don't buy from here probably these people will not have a livelihood, and I think the collection is very good this time and lot of social distancing is being maintained. You can see the circles around. You need to probably stand in the circles. So I think it's not a crowded place. It's a good place to shop and also help the small businessmen in terms of helping them in COVID. And I think everybody should come here and buy from here. Whatever I have seen so far, prices are really, really good. I see things from 20 rupees to 40 rupees to 70 rupees. And I think the the kind of variety I'm seeing this time, it is really, really good. And I think the prices are also tremendously low as compared to the market.
Terracotta and pottery is one of the approved crafts of Odisha, mostly practiced by the traditional Kumbhakars and trained youths almost in every district. There are more than 10,000 terracotta artisans in the state who are producing traditional, decorative and utility terracotta based items. Along with this, three terracotta artisans from Odisha have been conferred with national level awards and 18 terracotta artisans have been awarded state level awards. Moreover, with such exhibitions organized from time to time, help artisans to exhibit their craftsmanship and earn profits. And in these times of pandemic, when they were unable to sell their products, this terracotta exhibition was no less than a boon for them.
इन लोग का तो 6-7 महीना बैठ गए थे घर में, प्रोडक्ट का बना लिया लेकिन बेच नहीं पाए थे, बहुत तकलीफ में थे. ये उनको अच्छा एक अपॉर्चुनिटी प्लेटफॉर्म मिल गया सेलिंग करने के लिए.
Odisha has immensely rich craft tradition with magnificent craftsmanship. As many as 50 different crafts have been approved by the government of Odisha, practiced by more than 1.3 lakh artisans in varied degrees and are dispersed throughout the state. The handlooms, textiles and handicrafts department of the state too keeps on providing promotional supports for growth of the handicraft sector, including market assistance by organizing exhibitions.
Ingrained with rich values and various beliefs, India is known for its diverse religions and unique traditions. Since centuries, Sufi saints in India have been dispersing the message of peace and harmony among diverse religious communities. Their followers have faithfully absorbed their message and endeavored to maintain the secular fabric of the nation. The Dargah of Hazrat Khwaja Dana in Surat district of Gujarat is the manifestation of this bohemi between different religious communities of India. Take a look.
The land of India is interspersed with numerous sites which are serving as testimonies to the long-cherished brotherhood among myriad faiths prospering in the nation. The Dargah of Hazrat Khwaja Dana in Surat district of Gujarat is one such epicenter of religious harmony. Popular among locals and devotees, the Dargah is visited by Hindus, Muslims and believers from other religions alike.
यहाँ पे आके हमारी सब इच्छा पूरी होती है. हम एक ही धर्म, सब एक धर्म से मान के चलते हैं और यहाँ पे आके हमारी सब इच्छा पूरी होती है. जो भी मांगते हैं यहाँ पे सब पूरा होता है, इसलिए हम दर गुरुवार को यहाँ पे आते हैं. हमें अच्छा लगता है यहाँ आके और मन को शांति मिलती है.
The Dargah holds great significance as it welcomes people of all faiths to seek oneness with God and plays a distinctive role in narrowing the boundaries of religions and promoting communal harmony in the country. Community kitchen or langar is also set up at the outdoors to serve meals as holy sacrament to the devotees coming from different regions. Forming an integral part of the public ethos for the last several centuries, even today, the Sufi traditions play an important role in the lives of the people and connote them with an understanding of the world in all its spiritual dimensions.
सरकार की चौखट पर सभी लोग आते हैं, चाहे हिंदू हो, मुस्लिम हो, जो भी धर्म का हो. सरकार से इश्क रखने वाले, सरकार से चाहने वाले, मानने वाले, नाम लेवा सरकार की चाहत में सरकार के दर पर आते हैं. जैसा कि आप देख सकते हैं कितने लोग हिंदू आते हैं जो सरकार को दिल से चाहते हैं, दिल से मानते हैं, और जो मानताएं लेकर आते हैं, मन्नतें लेकर आते हैं, तमन्ना लेकर आते हैं, वो सरकार उनकी दुआओं को कबूल करते हैं, उनकी तमन्नाओं को कबूल करते हैं, उनकी मन्नतों को पूरी करते हैं।
This dargah sends out a message of love and peace for all, regardless of their religion. The Sufi saints who have laid this foundation of communal harmony in the country has only emboldened with time.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A temple elephant with unique hairstyle playing mouth organ in Tamil Nadu has become a huge attraction among the visitors. The female elephant, lovingly known as Bobcat Sengamalam, plays mouth organ with her trunk, leaving visitors impressed. Sengamalam was brought to the Raja Gopala Swami Temple in the state's Mannargudi town in 2003 and has been provided utmost care and treatment by her trainer, Raj Gopal, since then. Raj Gopal gave her the unique bob cut look and washes them 3 times a day during summers and at least twice a day in other seasons.
This elephant is so cute, hairstyles. It's also playing mouth against. I'm coming this temple, this elephant see that. So many people are come this see the elephant. Children are fun to see the elephants. This elephant see music, play the music also. So cutely like it.
Elephants are deeply revered in India, where the elephant-headed god Ganesha is one of the most popular in the Hindu pantheon and is also considered lucky.
Artists in the Jammu and Kashmir territory enthralled the audience with their performances of traditional folk theatre Bhand Pather amid the coronavirus pandemic. Artists dressed in colourful clothes danced to the tunes of traditional folk music, telling a tale of Kashmiris and their tribulations in a bid to revive the dying art of folk theatre and make people aware of its importance.
काफ़ी अरसे के बाद ये शो नए से स्टार्ट हुआ है, तो आज हमारा बस यही मकसद है कि जो आने वाली नई जनरेशन है वो प्रमोट हो जाए, वो आगे आ जाए, वो अपने कल्चर को जाने, ताकि उन्हें पता चले कि हमारा कश्मीर का कल्चर कैसा था और हमारा कल्चर जो है वो ज़िंदा रहे बाकी।
Bhand Pather was used as a medium to inform the commoners about the events in the state.
The Indian Space Research Organization recently launched 10 satellites into the Earth's orbit from its space station in Sriharikota Island for the first time after the coronavirus pandemic has hit the country. The Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle C-49 took one indigenous Earth observation satellite EOS-01 and 9 customer satellites of the USA, Luxembourg and Lithuania. It lifted off from the Satish Dhawan Space Center. EOS-01 is a radar imaging satellite that can take pictures in all weather conditions and will be useful in military, agriculture, forestry and disaster management support, as per media reports. It will work with radar imaging satellite 2B and 2BR-1, which were launched last year.
the PSLV C-49 successfully placed Earth Observation Satellite EOS-01 as well as 9 customer satellite precisely into the 575-kilometer orbit.
The customer satellites of the USA, Luxembourg and Lithuania are LEMUR, CLIOS and R2 and are intended for multi-mission remote sensing, maritime applications and technology demonstrations respectively.
Locals and social groups in India are looking at initiatives to bring environment-friendly celebrations to the Hindu festival of light, Diwali. Instead of the usual hard-to-dissolve clay and harmful chemicals for colouring of earthen lamps, plant pots and other items, a local government-supported social welfare group in Raipur city is using soil mixed with cow dung. The products made of this mixture would act as organic manure upon disposal.
अभी शासन के निर्देशानुसार इनको वर्तमान में दिया की मशीन निगम द्वारा और एक गमला बनाने की मशीन इसके साथ गो कास्ट मशीन गमले की गोबर की लकड़ी से इसके निर्माण के लिए प्रशिक्षण दिया गया और बहनें द्वारा इनका निर्माण किया जा रहा है। अभी लगभग 17 से 18,000 दिया इनके द्वारा बनाया गया है जिसको मार्केट में हम बेच रहे हैं और विभागों से भी हमको इसका डिमांड आ रहा है।
A similar scene was witnessed in Bhopal city where women, inspired by boycotting of Chinese goods, are making lamps, idols and other decorative items from cow dung. Cow is considered a sacred animal in Hinduism and its dung is used in many ways including organic manure and fuel among other things.
Having mutual tolerance and regards for each other's belief is a characteristic of Indian society. Emboldening this fact are a few Muslims in the Aligarh city of Uttar Pradesh who light up the evening of Hindu festival Diwali by making beautiful clay lamps. Today, let's take you to meet one such Muslim woman who has been doing this work for years now.
The festival of lights, Diwali, is just around the corner. Markets are flooded with customers who are busy buying decorated lamps to light up their houses at the new moon night. Though used during a Hindu festival, some of the dexterous hands behind these pieces of art are of Muslims residing in a small village in Aligarh. Khurshid Begum, who has been doing this work for the last 4-5 years, is one among them. Earlier, her husband Muhammad Idrish used to do this work, but when his health started deteriorating, she took over the charge.
I have been doing this for 4-5 years. When I was sick, I made a mess. I made a mess for Diwali.
For Khurshid, Diwali is the time when she works day and night to make a good business. By making clay lamps, she not just gets to earn a livelihood for her family, but at the same time spreads a message of brotherhood as well. Husband Idrish says that they feel elated when they see their lamps lighting up the houses of their Hindu brothers.
सबके घरों में हमें जब मुसलमान भी ले में हिंदू भी ले में
कैसा लगता है आपको उनके घर रोशन करने के
अच्छा लगता है सबके घरों में रोशनी हो अल्लाह करावे सबको सबको रोशनी करावे अल्लाह में
The The festivals in India are the medium to bring diversified cultures, traditions and religions in a peaceful communion where people dilute their differences and celebrate the unity of our country.
A famous saying goes, all men start unknown, but only a few finish great. In difficult times like that of the pandemic, a number of men and women have gone an extra mile to help the needy. While some have been distributing essential items to the poor, others have been making masks and protective gears. Doing something different from all, a woman in Srinagar district of Jammu and Kashmir is providing free sanitary kits to young girls and women amid the COVID-19 crisis. Have a look.
It is said that women are the building blocks of the society. Therefore, it's important to take care of their health if we want our society to progress. Creating awareness on menstrual hygiene thus becomes the foremost requirement, as it is estimated that around 120 million menstruating adolescents in India experience menstrual dysfunctions that affect their normal daily course. The major reason being that only 36% of the women in country use sanitary pads during periods. So, taking a step forward towards women's safety, a young Kashmiri woman, Irfana Zargar, has taken the initiative of distributing menstrual kits to women.
मेरे दिमाग में जब ये कॉन्सेप्ट आ गया तो फिर मैंने ये वॉशरूम्स में स्टार्ट किया 15 वॉशरूम्स का मतलब ये था कि मैं मतलब ये 15 वॉशरूम्स श्रीनगर सिटी में कवर करूं उसके बाद मैं विलेज में जाऊं बहनों की दुआएं होंगी भाइयों की साथ होगा तो इंशाल्लाह मैं ये ज़रूर करूंगी मैं चाहती हूं कि मतलब मैं ये आगे ले जाऊं ये मिशन और मैं ज़्यादा विलेज में करना चाहती हूं
स्टार्टेड अंडर द बैनर ईवा सेफ्टी किट इरफाना ज़रगर्स किट कंटेन्स All the essentials that are required for maintaining healthy menstrual practices like sanitary napkins, antispasmodics and hand wash. Irfana has installed these kits in around 15 public washrooms around Srinagar which are available at free of cost especially in case of an emergency. Each weekend, Irfana visits these washrooms to refill these empty kits. Locals too are lauding this unique initiative of Irfana.
बहुत अच्छा है ये जो अगर मतलब ये काम करती है इसमें आप इसमें उसको सवाब भी मिलते हैं और इंसानियत तौर भी है मतलब बहुत अच्छा है क्योंकि ये आप ये इसमें साबुन वाबुन रखती है वो सैनिटाइजर रखती है वो मतलब फ्री मतलब वो रखती है तो इसको सपोर्ट करना चाहिए अगर और भी कोई होगा उसको भी सपोर्ट करना चाहिए
Irfana even goes door to door to distribute these safety kits to young girls and women. She has dedicated the initiative to her late father, Ghulam Hassan Zargar. Every month, she invests a major portion of her salary towards making the menstrual products accessible to poor women.
ये तो बहुत अच्छा काम है क्योंकि जब लॉकडाउन था तो बहुत मुश्किल होती थी सबको यहाँ पे क्योंकि बाहर नहीं जा सकते थे तभी तो हमने इनसे कांटेक्ट किया तो इसने हमारी बहुत मदद की बहुत ज़्यादा तो हमारे लिए बहुत अच्छा था वो
इट इज़ ड्यू टू पीपल लाइक इरफाना दैट अ पॉजिटिव चेंज इज़ ब्रॉट इन द सोसाइटी एज दे नॉट जस्ट कीप द करेज टू ब्रेक द स्टीरियोटाइप्स but also try to make the people's lives better.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Yeshi and it's goodbye from the entire production team.